Here's how to stabilize shaky footage in Premiere Pro. First, bring your footage that you want to stabilize into your sequence, and it is best to have a higher resolution piece of footage than your sequence size. So in this case, we have a 4K shot on a 1080p sequence. Right-click the footage in the sequence and select Fit to Frame. The stabilizer will crop your footage, so it is best to make sure that we're not pre-cropping it. You can see that this piece of footage in particular has some handheld shakiness, but it's not horrible. Your best results using this method in Premiere Pro will of course depend on the severity of the shake in your footage. This is a great method, but it is by no means a magic tool that can fix everything. Go to your effects panel and search for Warp Stabilizer. Drag that onto your footage. It will automatically begin to analyze in the background, and you can see the progress of that in the effects controls panel. Once it analyzes to 100%, it will then stabilize your footage, and you shouldn't have to wait too long, especially if it is a short shot. You can see that out of the gate, this shot has reacted very well to the default settings of the Warp Stabilizer. But in the effects controls panel, you can change a few settings depending on your piece of footage. For instance, you can opt for how much, if any, you want the footage to be cropped. If we set it to stabilize only, for instance, you can see just how much movement has been taken out of the shot up in the corners here. In the advanced settings, you can turn on detailed analysis for particularly tricky shots. You can also kick up the intensity of things like the rolling shutter ripple and decide if you want to opt for a smoother shot or a less cropped shot. Now that all goes to say, if you do have a really shaky piece of footage like this one, and you throw all of the power of the Warp Stabilizer at it, you still may end up with something that looks like this. I'll let you be the judge of what's more usable. Let me know down in the comments how useful you find the Warp Stabilizer to be in real projects, and with this shot in particular, would you use the shaky one in the edit or would you use the stabilized one? This video is brought to you by Envato, the unlimited creative subscription. The broadest range of categories, everything that you need to make great videos. Follow the link in the description and start creating now.